There are no questions?
Yes,
no.
Here,
okay, please, please.
To Lorenzo, please. So, when you use the stimulation and you conclude about the functional sensitivity of each area, how do you know, or do you know at all about the spread of stimulation, what's the effect of that, and so on? How do you know how focal the stimulation is?
Yeah, in fact, according to the time that I had to talk, I didn't go through to the specific neurophysiological details, but this data has been acquired by monopolar and high frequency stimulation using one pulse, the minimum current threshold, and of course checking to MEP amplitude and to the latency. You have seen that the data were quite extensive, and thanks to that we were quite sure that the focality of the stimulation.
Dr. Gil Robles, please.
Thank you. I would like to ask a question to Johan and Hugues. Particularly in the insular gliomas, there is, of course, this technical difficulty, functional and vascular difficulty. How do you manage with time, with timing? Because we can't keep the patient awake. I don't know what's your experience, but more than 2 hours seems to be really difficult. So how do you manage your strategy before surgery to deal with this timing limitation you have and this extended intraoperative stimulation?
Yeah, we'll begin first to answer to that. I showed that in my practice there is a long phase of surgical resection after the awake procedure, because I try to use the time of awake procedure, which is 1 to 2 hours, no more, to make my all efforts to identify the functional boundaries. And after that, we can convert into the sleep phase to push through. In one case, I stopped the resection due to patient fatigue. Also, I did not identify my functional boundaries. So in one case, I had to stop and to make a second surgery 9 months later.
Okay, yes, so you need a good anesthesiologist.
Of course, of course. You need a very good anesthesiologist.
Yes. Yeah, please.
Of course, and related to that question, in fact, the insula itself, do you take out the insula itself with the patient awake or asleep?
Oh, as a rule, the transopercular approach and the insular removal itself, I do it during the awake phase.
Okay, so
most of the time.
You remove the insula itself awake, with the patient awake.
But in some cases, some remnants lying over the pial limits without any functional dilemma here, I will complete it in the second part and sleep.
Okay. Hugues, you share this opinion?
I agree. In fact, I changed a little bit my mind with experience, because initially I would like to remove the tumor in general during wake mapping, and especially in insular tumor. And in fact, I had some patients a little bit tired at the end of surgery. It's a question frequently raised in meetings. And now, probably due to the fact that we started to better understand really functional anatomy and the minimal common brain, I have the habit to go directly into the contact of the dangerous areas in order to use the patient, optimally speaking, after the awakening, generally 10 to 20 minutes after, the patient is perfectly able to help you regarding even very demanding cognitive tasks, adjunct tasks, mentalizing, and so on. And then to have not only the cortical mapping, finally, now I do the cortical mapping just in 5 to 10 minutes, that's it. I have not so much the habit to do many stimulation. And then I go into the contact of the functional boundaries in order to do the subpial resection of the operculae, as I said, so approximately 10 to 15 minutes maximum. So after 30 minutes, you are into the contact of the insula and the circular sulcus. And if the tumor is very bulky and sometimes adherent to the vessels, I can take a retractor in order to go under the insula invaded by the tumor, because it's really a mass, and to stimulate in order to identify the IFOF, the RQ8, SLF, and so on. And then finally, you have your deep limit. You did, of course, the surgical approach, and you have sometimes the bulky tumor into the contact of the sylvian arteries, the orbitofrontal part, the temporopolar part, and you can do that under general anesthesia. So that means that in general now, finally, the awake period, I don't know for you, the experience is finally less than 1 hour, more and more, while when I was younger, it was 2 hours, and I said sometimes, please give me more time because I need to remove more tumor, but now you can go faster and faster.
This is very interesting.
Thank you.
Are there any difference between the junior and senior for timetable? Yeah, please. Because it's very interesting.
Haven't looked at it, but I can imagine that there's a difference, yeah. And I think there are probably more staged procedures, multi-stage procedures for these large tumors at the beginning of the learning curve than later on. Because you're not so sure where you will be identifying function as you are. So you're stimulating and removing and stimulating and removing. That takes half an hour, more.
In fact, I should say more and more, but probably with the not only the experience, but the modification of my philosophy throughout 15 to 20 years, that intraoperative electrical mapping is very important. We are speaking about that very frequently. But the most important today to me is the intraoperative cognitive monitoring online. So if you have a good team around you, in fact, you feel protected also, because not only you know where you are, but you have the feedback. And then you have also the validation of your mental imagery. And this is the reason why I'm anxious if I had, I would be anxious if I had to perform surgery under general anesthesia now, because I would have to wait for the awakening of the patient following surgery to be sure that I did the job. Why, now I'm sure, so you can go faster also. So the monitoring, cognitive monitoring, is much more important. And Mitch Berger said that also in Los Angeles. He said, or in Greece, I think, we had the discussion, and he said, we've experienced more and more now, sometimes I stimulate, you have disturbances, but if with the CUSA I have nothing, finally I will continue because the patient is perfect according to the task I decided to administrate at this moment. So that means that more and more electrical mapping is an adjunct to the primary goal, which is the neuropsychological examination, in my experience at least.
So it's true. You need a very important and nice team in your operating theater.
And once again, PhD, to my opinion, in cognitive neuroscience. I mean, neurologists, neurosurgeons, neuropsychologists, speech therapists, everyone should speak the same language.
Yes.
By telling, for instance, we have a problem of theory of mind, you should not stop by telling what you said, I don't understand. I mean, to have this level of communication online allowing to avoid to waste time.
Yeah, it's interesting. Any questions? No questions? No? Now we can continue with 2 videos from... No? Yes. Yes, please, please. We have time, no? If you want... Because we just 5 minutes for 2 videos from Dr... Yeah, Dr. Ifo. Yes. We can continue with the discussion. Please, sit down. Here, near me. Very nice. Okay, please.